So, you want to play Honkai Impact the Third? I assume you're a Genshin player who reached endgame and now is stuck in a never-ending cycle of doing dailies, using your resin, and then logging off. You still love the game, but want to find anything else that can fill its place. Well, you are in luck. Our Lord and Savior miHoYo actually has another game that is filled with content waiting for you to complete. Even still, it might prove to be a bit complicated at the start for a beginner. That's why I, with my 4 years of experience, will act as your guide on this journey. So, without any further delay, I welcome you to the world of Honkai Impact. I feel it is best to start off with the story mode, since that's the first thing you do after you open the game. Right off the bat, I should mention that this story covers far harsher themes than Genshin's, like manipulation, corruption, war, death, depression, human experimentation, and even suicide. So, if you find these kinds of themes disturbing, I would advise you not to play it. However, if you aren't bothered by these hard subjects, it is a story that you must experience. It is not only the best narrative experience in any gacha game for now, I dare say it is even one of the best video game stories. As a quick synopsis, you start by meeting the main character Kiana Katsuana, a Valkyrie who is fighting against the Honkai, which are sentient beings with the mission of destroying the planet. Later on, Kiana is accompanied by our two other protagonists, Raiden Mei and Bronya Zajcik. The first few chapters are centered on the trio and their endeavors in the Saint Freya High School, where Valkyries such as themselves are being trained. At the start, everything is mostly peaceful and fun, but that quickly changes at around chapter 6 with the fourth Hersher eruption. But to avoid spoilers, I won't be going any further than that. I would really recommend you to go and play it for yourself, and the best part is that it won't take you that long to catch up. I would say the most you would need if you take your time is a day or two. Well, now that we have seen a bit of the story, let's move on to the gameplay and find out if it is any good. Honkai Impact is a hack and slash, and its controls are really easy to get used to, but also pretty hard to master if you want to play competitively. Before you go inside the mission, you first have to choose your characters. Your team consists of 3 different Valkyries, mainly a DPS, a support, and the third one can either be another support or a second DPS. Keep in mind that the placement of the characters in your party matters, since the leader, or the one in the front, has a leader bonus, which differs from character to character. As I said before, the controls are fairly easy to understand. You have your standard attack and evade buttons, as well as the character weapon skill, special skill, and ultimate. Weapon skills are unique for every single weapon and are extremely important if you wish to reach higher damage numbers. However, if you only want to play casually, you will probably forget that it even exists most of the time, which is a shame since they are just as important, if not more so, than the ultimate. Speaking of the ultimates, they are what you would expect from any game. Some are amazing at dishing out consistent damage like deltas, and then there are more supportive types like Azure Empress. Finally, we have special attacks. There are 4 separate types: combo, charge, charged, and switch. Switch is the easiest one to explain. Basically, whenever you switch to that character, on entry they will do an attack, which is fine, but I find it to be a bit weak. Charge is primarily used by Himiko for now. For you to execute them, you just need to hold the attack button and then release it to deal damage. Charged is an attack type that uses a meter that must first be filled. After filling up your meter, you then have to hold the attack button to unleash your special. And finally, there is the combo variant. Charged and combo are pretty similar in the sense that you need to first fill a meter to use them. But then, instead of just holding and activating the skill, some characters may require you to first do a simple combo. And that's basically it for combat mechanics, explained in as simple way as possible. Of course, there are other stuff like different dodge effects for different characters, but those I will explain in later videos. We got to learn about teams and gameplay a bit, now it's time to learn how to upgrade our Valkyries. Well, there are 2 main ways of doing it: equipping better weapons and equipping stigmatas. For the weapons, it is pretty self-explanatory. Higher rarity weapons mean higher stats. However, there is also one more thing that should be considered, and that is the weapon skill. You should be keeping an eye out for them, since some skills can be useful to some Valkyries and totally useless to others. After you have picked a better weapon, you would want to look into your stigmatas. Stigmata are just like the artifacts in Genshin, but with some differences. Firstly, every set has 3 pieces: top, middle, and bottom. Each stigmata has its own skills that they put in the character, and if you combine 2 or 3 of the same set, you receive a set bonus. Pretty similar to Genshin so far, but there is one more thing. Stigmatas also have their own affixes, which are like bonus substats that boost your character. Now, if you are unlucky and your stigmata has bad affixes, there is a system that lets you reroll for a chance of better ones called Refine. Or, as I like to call it, every Genshin player's wet dream. As you would expect, there are all sorts of stigmata. From physical, to elemental, to more support-oriented ones. So you should experiment with them to see which ones you find the strongest. And if you can figure them out quite well in the early stages, you shouldn't worry, because miHoYo has provided us with guides for every character. From which characters synchronize well with each other, to possible builds for different skill levels, as well as builds for different game modes. Keep in mind that these guides, while helpful early on, can be deceiving at times, so you should take them with a grain of salt when you're approaching the later stages of the game. Well, that's about it for gameplay and systems, so now we can move on to finding out what exactly can you expect in terms of game modes, events, and endgame. In the beginning, you only have story mode unlocked, which will be your only source for gaining experience. Luckily, early on you level up quite fast, so when you finish chapter 2 part 6, you will be at level 16, which will unlock the material events, and then, at level 18, or when you have finished chapter 2 part 12, you will unlock the open world Sakura Samsara. This will be your farming places early on. The story not only gives you a great narrative experience, but it also grants you tons of crystals, low-end stigmata, coins, and other upgrade materials. The material event is the place where you would farm a specific material that you may need, be it XP chips, weapon and skill upgrade materials, and others. Keep in mind that the materials switch around each day, so if you want something specific, you should take it while you can. Finally, there is also the open world, which is the best place to farm during most of your playtime. Every Monday, Thursday, and Saturday, you will be given 5 adventure tasks. When you complete them, they will give you a specific reward, be it materials, XP, coins, for character shards, which I will be talking about shortly. Sakura Samsara is going to be your first open world, and then, at level 40, you will unlock a post-Honkai Odyssey, which is best described as an open world Devil May Cry. And then, at level 50, you unlock Shixel HQ, your third and final open world. Personally, I would say once you unlock a post-Honkai Odyssey, you should be grinding only it, since it gives the best rewards. Unless, of course, you need something specific from the other two. After those three game modes, at level 24, you will unlock Chronicles, which are bonus story missions dedicated to a specific Valkyrie. For those who are obsessed with the lore of the story just like me, they would be able to provide you with some interesting content, but won't be anything special in terms of gameplay. Now, we go to the content that is a bit harder, starting with co-op raids. They unlock at level 35 and should be a priority for the newer players, as when they clear a certain raid, they will receive a 4-star weapon, so if you're just starting out, you shouldn't miss them. And if you have an experienced player on your team, they can just carry you to the finish line. The final two major game modes are the Memorial Arena as well as the Abyss. Memorial Arena is unlocked at level 38 and it is a 5-staged boss fight where each stage gets progressively harder. After beating it a couple of times, it rewards you with crystals, character shards, and ancient willpower, a material used for buying character shards. Not only does it give you some pretty nice rewards, but it also acts as your first competitive area where people can try to beat each other's high scores. Finally, we have the Abyss, which you will unlock at level 25, but you probably won't go far at that level. It is a competitive rank-based race. With every rank, the difficulty of the stages gets harder, and to add more competitiveness, only 3 people get to be promoted from the 3rd stage onwards. To make it even harder, a few points can make the difference between being promoted or not. So, it means that you need to use a well-built team and must be playing perfectly if you want to compete. Other than that, the Abyss is the perfect place for farming crystals, so don't forget to do it when you reach a big enough level. And now we have reached the events. With events, it's probably best to expect the unexpected. One time, there might be nothing interesting or special, and the next time, there can be a mini-game with chibi Valkyries with guns fighting mini-monsters. Even now, the most recent event introduced a whole new semi-open world. To make it even better, with every event, there is an event shop that offers really good rewards that make you want to stay and farm. Unlike some other game. And that was it for the game modes and events. Now, with all these modes, you probably wonder how do I actually get new characters and equipment? Well, it's a miHoYo game, so you already know the answer. Surprisingly, Honkai Impact is pretty free-to-play friendly. I myself am not a total free-to-play since I have bought 2 or 3 monthly passes, but most of my crystals have come from me farming and saving and I have managed to get almost every character, some good weapons and stigmata. You could even manage to get a top-up costume if you save well enough. Some tips when you decide to pull are to never waste crystals on the dorm supply. You occasionally receive dorm pulls, so you should only use them. it is best to pull on the expansion supply when it comes for new characters and on the focus supply for equipment. The expansion weapon supply may guarantee you the new equipment, but it is only after 50 pulls, and then you get only 1 out of the 4. So, if you don't have enough crystals, you should probably skip it. After you have pulled a few times, you probably will start getting duplicates of your characters. Do not be disappointed. Just like Genshin has constellations, Honkai has character ranks which are upgraded with character shards, which you get from either farming them or by pulling duplicates. Just keep in mind that you can farm every single Valkyrie, but it is a good amount and the shop has some really strong options, like these 4. Don't expect to get them fast though, it will be a long and hard journey, especially if you want to triple S them, but it will be worth it in the end. There are some guides showing you who is the strongest and what have you, but at the end of the day, just play whoever you enjoy the most and pull for the characters that you find interesting. And that was about everything. There are some stuff that I missed out, but I will leave them for you to discover. The last thing left to do is for you to join the world of Honkai Impact and to start your journey. See you on the Hyperion!